Welcome to Learning by Short Show, bites of information you get to apply immediately. We're wrapping up our Drive Sales Culture. This is the last video in the series. I really trust you've enjoyed it and that it's been really useful for you. Like any program that you work through or any learning that you do, the information is only as good as the action that you get to take as a result of having it. We've gone through each of the letters using Drive Sales as an acronym to hang on various points, thoughts, actions that you can take. If you've implemented them, we'd be delighted to know some of your success stories. We've wrapped up this last week looking at how do you sustain future work? How do you use all these great actions that you've done to keep the work flowing? And we started off talking with that final concept of keeping the sustaining the work that keeps coming in, talking about having a client management plan. I'd like to leave this thought with you as we wrap up this whole program. Having a plan is only as good as your ability to execute on the plan. And like many plans, it won't always go to plan. But much like a plane that's taking off, at least it knows where it wants to land. Now, if you got into an airplane and you took off and it went, oh, this is a pilot and just welcome on board, we're not sure where we're quite going, but we'll get there eventually, I suppose. That's hardly going to instill confidence inside of you. Likewise with your plan and with your team. You get to craft and create your culture. You get to choose how you will be seen by your customers, how your internal culture will be reflected in the external customer experience. Craft the plan and then work the plan. Make sure that you're checking in on the plan, going, are we on track? Are we not on track? You want to make sure that you're able to do the little deviations and the little course corrections along the way. When we're able to do that, what ends up happening is that we learn as we go and are able to iterate and go, oh, what did we learn from that? What do we need to start doing? What do we need to stop doing? What do we need to continue doing to keep learning from our successes and from the things that haven't gone so well? When we create a culture of continuous learning, it allows us to go and have a culture of continuous improvement. I do trust that this has served you well, that you're able to apply it and implement it. Work together with your team, and here's all the very best to your success. If any of this resonated with you and you'd like some help with it, do feel free to get in touch. Drop me an email at mike@thinkright.co.nz or 0272 987 523 or our website www.thinkright.co.nz.